The membership remained the same, the platform remained the same, and the quest to make political rule exclusive to ethnic Ukrainians remained the same. The Svoboda Party is headed by Oleg Tikhnobok. Ever since 2014, this man, 2004, this man has been persistently pursuing a mission to cleanse and purify Ukrainian politics from non-Ukrainian elements, who merely by virtue of not being ethnic Ukrainians are to be expelled from politics by any means necessary. In 2004, Tikhnobok made an infamous speech in which he called on ethnic Ukrainians to fight against, and I quote, Muscovite Jewish mafia that wants to take over the Ukrainian state. To make matters worse, the party Svoboda regularly stages demonstrations honoring the infamous Stepan Bandera and his Ukrainian insurgent army, whose attempts to establish an independent Ukrainian state led to the appalling acts of ethnic cleansing, including the massacres of Poles, Russians, and Jewish people in Western Ukraine. The Svoboda Party sees Bandera as its intellectual forefather, and it determined to continue his legacy. This was always been Svoboda's character, but through highly disturbing, it posed no real danger to Ukraine, as the party lacked any real political leverage. Now that has changed. Svoboda has grown drastically, gaining substantial popular support in the country's west, and since the Maidan coup, it enjoys an unprecedented degree of political pull. Let us tell you, in very concrete terms, the extent to which Svoboda wields political power in Ukraine, and what exactly it does in exercising it. Stay tuned. The evidence of Svoboda's barbarism is coming up in our next speech. Ban Svoboda! Ban Svoboda! Ban Svoboda! Ban Svoboda! Svoboda! Ban Svoboda! Ban Svoboda!
Ban Svoboda! Ban Svoboda!